Live on Fox Sports Detroit is presented by Arby's. Hello, everybody, and welcome to this Halloween edition of Red Wings Live, coming at you from our Southfield studios on this Saturday night in the Motor City. Trevor Thompson, Manny Legacy, and Chris Osgood at your service. And fellas, it's kind of appropriate that this game falls on Halloween because the Wings have looked kind of scary lately. They've lost 6 of their last 7, including last night's front end of this home-and-home with the Senators from Ottawa. Ozzie, sum up what you've seen over the stretch.
I've seen them struggling for the first couple games, obviously, and now it's a lack of confidence, squeezing the stick much too tight, too many tough plays out of the zone. They got to go back to simplifying their game, really just getting back to getting pucks in the zone, forechecking, getting some hits, getting some skin on skin, getting pucks to the net, and being more physical in front of both nets.
Yeah, I agree, but turnovers, big time. They can't be relying on their goaltending. The goaltending's actually been pretty solid over this little stretch here, but they can't be relying on him making big saves, 3-4. Per period, mm-hmm. To start winning hockey games.
We'll see what happens tonight. But tonight, the Sens are looking for a third straight win. The Wings are hoping to prevent a third straight loss. And with more insight into how they're hoping to make that happen, let's take you to the Canadian Tire Center now and join John Keating, who's with the Wings head coach. Keats?
Trev, thanks. Let's be clear. Right now, the Red Wings are your teenage daughter. There are lots of issues swirling around them, but that doesn't make you love them any less. You can check off goaltending, as the guys in the studio just mentioned. That's been fine. But beyond that, a list of concerns. The primary worry right now is getting the puck out of your own zone. If that doesn't change quickly, the Red Wings, you could make the case, are going to have to start paying rent at one end of the ice.
I think we've done a better job of that through lots of the games through the season as we've moved along. We keep track of zone time. We've had the majority, more zone time offensively than defensively in really every game except for the back-to-back game. So we have to continue to do that. Now the key, the next step, I think, is increasing that. So instead of being a minute and a half on the positive side, let's be in the 3 minutes. Let's be in the 4 minutes. Now they've got something to say about it too. They're making it tough on you too. But I think we can continue to increase that time.
In their stretch of ugly, in this stretch of 1-5-1, the Red Wings have scored a total of 12 goals. When they went 3-0 to start the year, they scored 11. So something to watch as tonight's game gets going, that first pass and making some headway through the neutral zone. Those things have to happen if the Red Wings are to relocate their smiles here in Ottawa tonight. Trev?
All right, Keats, thanks a lot. We'll have more from John in Ottawa in just a bit. But guys, the Wings really seem to be searching right now, searching for line combos that work, searching for some consistency, and certainly searching for an identity early this season. Manny, is really, does success for this team begin with getting the little things done first?
Yeah, when you're struggling and you're trying to find something, you've got to keep it simple. But like Keith said, that first pass is so big, getting out of your zone, limiting the zone time here. You watch, just little giveaways here, turnovers back and forth. Now it's back another shot on here. Here's that little simple, just little touch pass. You've got to make that pass. Then, look, more zone time. Ottawa's got more zone time here. And here's another little turnover here. You've got to be strong. You're going up the middle of the ice here. That's got to be a hard rocket pass and up through the middle, not a little soft touch. Everything's got to be crisp in your own zone. More zone time. Just but if all of this happens on the first pass here, he's trying to go middle. You've got to be 100% going up that middle and make that good one zone pass.
I think they're a victim of analytics, honestly. I mean, really? They're trying to handle the puck too many times when they shouldn't be. Everybody talks puck possession. Whoever controls the puck the most wins all the time. Well, the Calgary Flames proved that not to be true last year. And I think this year they feel the pressure. They're a very good possession team last year. This, so far this year, not so good. They're holding on to it when they shouldn't. And they're a quick team. They have a very good skating team. Chip it ahead. Get the speed through the middle. Chip it down in the zone. Get a forecheck going. Their forecheck has been non-existent for the first 10 games. They got to get some skin on skin. Get some hits. And use their speed. Don't hold on to it for so long.
And in some of those plays Manny just showed us, Oz, they look a little soft in front of their own net. You got to toughen up in front of your own net.
That's an understatement. I mean, when you're nestling the puck in front of your own net, bad things are going to happen. The Red Wings have gotten away with it. Reason being, their goaltending has been off the charts for the first 10 games. And really, they've been very porous in front of their own net. Call it the house, call it whatever you want. You got to protect that area in front of Mrazek and Howard. And they just haven't done it, whether it's taking sticks or getting the body. I'd love to see a couple penalties tonight in front of their net where they're knocking somebody on their keister, knocking them down, making them pay for standing in front of their... That goal right there drives me nuts. That goal is way too easy. I see that goal in Pee Wee games at the Plymouth Rec Center by my house. That can never, ever happen.
What about Manny being tougher in front of the other guys' net? That's where the dirty goals are scored.
Well, especially when you're going through a slump like this, you need to get those little dirty, greasy goals where it's going to hit you, bang in off of their defenseman, and in that, you know, disrupting their goalie's game.
Right.
You know, you're going to see Anderson tonight. So it just get in his face all night long and just get some greasy goals.
And those are a few of the things we'll look for between the Wings and the Sens here tonight. And here's a reminder to stay tuned to Red Wings Live following the game when we will select the Fox Sports Detroit Red Wings player of the game. It is presented by McDonald's, where you can stop by for your breakfast favorites. They're now being served all day long. Coming up as the show rolls on, the Sens could be scary good if they get both of their goaltenders playing up to their potential. We'll take a closer look at how and why as we roll on here tonight. And some feel this Red Wings team isn't showing enough bite. Maybe it's time someone gets Cronwalled. That could inspire the troops. We'll discuss as the show rolls on as well. And trick or treat time with the Wings as we look at some of the scariest things in NHL history. That and a whole lot more is coming your way on this Saturday night in our Fox Sports Detroit studios here on Red Wings Live. Red Wings Live is brought to you by your local Toyota dealers. Visit buyatoyota.com. Toyota, let's go places. And by Motor City Casino Hotel. Trevor Thompson, Manny Legacy, and Chris Osgood getting you set for the Wings and Sens from Canada's capital this evening. Also, getting you fantasy players ready for tonight, too. It's time for tonight's picks. They are sponsored by DraftKings. Manny, start us off. What's your team look like?
I think Ozzie and I are going to put the team together here. Okay. So I'm going to go with Fleury in net. He's playing Toronto. Toronto's struggling. And he's been hot of late the last couple weeks. And I also got from Pitt, Phil Kessel, going into Toronto. He's going to have a lot of energy back in that building. And then on D, I'm going to have Victor Hedman. He's leading Tampa right now with 10 points, and he's playing a struggling Boston team. So looking to him, it's all assists right now, just loading up Stamkos with 5 goals. But I'm looking for him to have a big night.
Yeah, my first pick, Carlson, and who wouldn't? This guy's one of the best skaters in the league. 10 assists, one in each of his last two. This guy, and looking fabulous, by the way, in his photo, but easy pick there. And obviously, then I got to go with Ovechkin, obviously. This guy, 32 goals in 52 career games versus the Panthers, not looking as good as Hedman in that shot. He wishes he could have taken it over again. And then I got to go with my favorite. This is my man, Crush Zetterberg. How can't I pick this guy? Each and every game, he's the best player for this Red Wing team. I don't care how old he is, how young he is, where he is, what rink he's in. Just a great player, great leader on and off the ice. How can't you pick that man?
You guys could win a little loot with that team. Pretty nice team.
I hope so. Well, I don't win a lot anymore.
I'm a big fantasy guy. I'm not winning anything yet, but on to the next. We'll play one day fantasy hockey for huge cash prizes on DraftKings.com, the official one day fantasy sports partner of the Detroit Red Wings. And you can play for free with the promo code FLOAT. Back to the Wings and the Sens. Craig Anderson has shown he can be one of the best in the business when he's on his game. Beating him will be a challenge that the Wings will have to solve tonight. A closer look at him coming up next as Red Wings Live. Red Wings Live is brought to you by Priority Health, Michigan's healthier approach to healthcare. And by ZotAuto.com, home of Chrysler, Jeep, Dodge, Ram, Ford, Toyota, and Scion. Well, Andrew Hammond got the start and the win last night for the Sens at the Joe. Tonight, Ottawa turns to its main man between the pipes, Craig Anderson. He's looking for his 5th win of the season, but he knows it won't be easy against a Red Wings team that has beat him the last 2 times they faced him, and they're desperate to make it a 3rd straight as they look to right the ship tonight.
They've been good. They've been good for a long time, and, winning hockey is kind of a habit, and they've got that habit, so... they got a good team and they're used to winning and winning a lot. So for them, they do things right and they do it right all the time. That they give themselves the best chance to win. And they're going to be, a tough team to play against. They always have been.
And here's a reminder that if a Detroit player scores a hat trick in this game, you can bring a copy of the scoring summary to a participating Arby's location and get a free small order of curly fries. You can find the scoring summary in your newspaper or on the Red Wings page at foxsportsdetroit.com. Up next on the show, We salute Halloween with a look at some of the scariest faces the NHL has to offer. Well, scary in a different sort of way, not just to look at, but you'll see what I mean when you join us after this quick timeout here on Red Wings Live. We salute the occasion with a look at some of the all-time great Halloween names from the NHL in tonight's Xfinity Look Around the League, and we'll start it off with Windsor native Adam Graves. Then there's the unforgettable Miroslav Shatan. And then, of course, there's Adam Deadmarsh. He makes the list, as does Jim Boo. Then there's the ever-popular Stu the Grim Reaper Grimson. Jonas the Monster Gustafsson makes the cut, as does your former teammate Manny Curtis Cujo Joseph. And I'm less familiar with Elf the Embalmer Pike, but the name fits the game. So he's in. And as these guys will tell you, it's the women behind the scenes who make things go for these guys. Erik Karlsson and his girlfriend Melinda Curry dressed up as Ursula and the Little Mermaid at a party this week. That's pretty scary, boys.
That's scary.
That is scary.
TJ Oshie and his wife Lauren dressed as Cura DeVille and a Dalmatian. Getting in the Halloween spirit right there, guys.
That's
and Steve
Ott
and his wife Erica are geeked up for next year's release of the movie Suicide Squad. They dressed as Harley Quinn and the Joker. Gotta like that. But maybe the best of all is Zdeno Chara and his minions visited a children's hospital in Boston leading up to Halloween, certainly bringing some smiles to some kids in need indeed. And our John Keating is in Ottawa. He's dressed up as a broadcaster tonight and looking for some treats in the form of a Red Wing win. But he'll also accept any candy he can get his hands on. That's really the reality for Keating every day of the week, isn't it, Keats?
Well, Trev, the Wings had to have looked at the schedule and let out an audible groan because, darn the luck, they had, you know, this game to be played on Halloween. So they held their annual Halloween party a few weeks ago. So the players had to deal with probably people walking by and wondering why they were all dressed up, but still you could make the case that perhaps Justin Abdelkader and his girlfriend Julie were the runaway winners for the best costume. They had full body paint going on as they were dressed up as characters from Avatar. I'm pretty sure they weren't Smurfs here, but it got us to thinking, what is your best ever Halloween costume worn?
Well, hockey or football player when I was a kid. As I got older, I was a clown. I'm trying to think, because Gumby last year.
How did the Gumby thing work out?
It was all right. I thought, me, Riley, and Lashoff all were Gumby, and I was like, oh, no one will be able to tell who's who. But then I looked at pictures and realized I'm 6 inches shorter than those guys, so I was sticking out like a sore thumb.
I went as Jackie Moon one year from the Flint Tropics. I thought that one worked out pretty good. And last year, I went as Pippi Longstocking. That one turned out decent as well.
That's beautiful.
We won't touch the college Halloween costumes. Those get a little rated R.
Were there good ones?
Yeah, I can leave it at that.
With a great deal of creativity attached
to it? A great deal of creativity, my kind of creativity, I'd say.
All right, but not necessarily for the family audience.
Not necessarily for the family audience.
My most memorable one was in college when four of us went as Kiss, and we got we had an artist in school, and she painted our face, and it was honestly we looked fantastic. So I'll see if I can try to get you a picture of it, but it was pretty good, and we actually did. There was like a couple concerts, and one of the guys that was in the four of us could sing, so he ended up. We got on stage. We were just no, we weren't really even playing. They had the background music, but he was singing, so it was pretty cool.
Well, of course we asked all those guys, are there pictures available of some of those costumes? They paused and said, yeah. Could we see those pictures of some of those costumes? Absolutely not, they all said, pretty much in unison. Over the course of the next 2.5 hours, they will be hockey players here on Halloween. Trev, Manny, Ozzy.
All right, Keith, thanks a lot. As we continue with our Halloween theme in this segment, we'll look at some of the scariest men in the league, and by scary, I mean scary good at what they do. Ozzy, let's start the list with the scariest coach in the NHL.
I'm going to go with the guy who was my general manager with the New York Islanders. This is Mike Milbury, number 8 for the Bruins. 26, my miss. He's in the stands here. He's going to grab a shoe off one of the fans.
This is the best part right here.
And just starts hammering him over the head. Now, when I played from the island, and this is true, he was intimidating. When he'd come down in the dressing room, we would scatter. And on the plane, when we lost, we knew he was mad, and he started walking down the island. We'd be running for cover as far as we could on the airplane. But this guy, not only intimidating the crowd, but continued on as he coached us and managed us in the island.
Scariest hitter, Manny?
Oh, Wendell Clark, for sure. Look at Boone.
Oh.
He used to just catch so many D, and then you just drop them. After you hit him, you used to run at him. Boom, let's go. He hit so many D coming around that net, and I got the pleasure to watch him growing up. I was a Toronto kid, so got to watch him every night, and he used to just heads up and just not afraid to throw the body. And he wasn't a very big man, eh, was he, guys?
Yeah, he took no games off ever. He came to Detroit late in his career, and because of hits like this, he could barely move. But wow, what an entertaining player for many years, one of the best captains Toronto Maple Leafs have ever had.
Both of you guys are qualified to answer this one. Scariest shot?
Well, this shot was so good, it scored on me from that distance. And I'm a hard guy to beat.
Center ice.
Now, that's an absolute C&I rocket. You don't see that very often. I had absolutely no chance. And this one right here, thank goodness I wasn't in for that. But this guy once took a shot and broke my hand. And was one of the reasons why I had to retire early, Manny.
Well, the good thing about his shot is everybody would get out of the way. You know, so at least he saw it coming.
Yeah. I played with
him.
He was
just an absolute rocket.
I played with him in St. Louis. He always kept a shot on the ice, along the ice, in practice, because he was afraid of hurting somebody. That's how hard it was.
Manny, scariest player.
Oh, my God. I was at Chris Chelios' golf tournament, and he was there, and he was in the restaurant when I walked out. That's how scared of this man I was. I'm like, he just looked at me, and I'm like, yep, I'm gone. You know, he was one of the toughest in the
exactly.
In the NHL.
Teddy bear off the ice, not so much on the ice. This guy was a huge man. Natural strength was unmatched by any player in the National Hockey League. Great player, had more offensive talent than you give him credit for, but what a player when he's with the Wings.
Ozzy, scariest uniforms.
I don't know what that is.
You wore that?
Osgood.
You wore that?
That looks like something that should be on a skateboard. That orange jersey was ridiculous. I have one of those at home. My son loves it, and I don't like it so much.
I don't know who designed these, but they should have been punched by Bob Probert. Like, these are horrendous jerseys in Vancouver.
And I used to love those growing up out west. I love Vancouver.
Those are terrible.
The King Richard Berger.
Scariest mask, Manny?
Oh, Gary the Bones, Bromley. Look at that thing. That gave me nightmares when I looked it up the other day.
He's giving goalies a bad name. When you're wearing that, you're not all there, obviously. And he's one of the guys.
What goes with his nickname, Bones?
He's one of the guys in the goalie fraternity that gives us a bad name. But wow, what a scary looking mask that was.
That thing is awesome.
That was like that Jerry Cheever's Jason-like mask with the stitches all over. That was a pretty cool mask.
Growing up as a kid, just put one in there.
Yeah, I love that one. That was my favorite. All right, as we push closer to game time, we'll come back with an on-ice chat with Nicholas Cromwell, a scary individual on ice himself. That's coming your way next as Red Wings Live continues to roll on here on Halloween. This capital is the site as the Wings look to snap out of their funk. Losers of five of the last six, they'll look to right the ship tonight. And as we head closer to game time, our John Keating is standing by with their leader on the blue line, Nicholas Cromwell.
All right, Trev, thanks. How perplexed are you by this stretch of seven games?
You know, it's been a rough go, no doubt. But we can't feel sorry for ourselves. Got to go back to work and get some wins going.
Your team was 3-0. What's the leadership group's message to the younger players who are coming up to sort of stay the course here?
Oh, we got to try to do it right every time. I haven't been at my best, and I need to be a lot better than I have. Hank can't be pulling the whole team.
Goals have been almost impossible to come by. How much do you just need a couple of them to go in to breathe a little bit tonight?
Well, you need a few dirty ones, and everything comes down to doing the little things right. Get the pucks in there, create some chaos, and go from there.
Go get them tonight.
Thank you.
Nicholas Cromwell and the Red Wings are wearing the home reds on the road here in Ottawa tonight, Trev.
All right, Keats, good stuff, guys. Nicholas Cromwell and the Wings looking to get back. Desperately needed 2 points tonight and get back in the win column. Let's have a quick look at who could impact tonight's outcome on both sides as we get set to fire away at our one-timers. Manny, shoot.
Yeah, Peter Mrazek's first time back in Ottawa since he played with the Ottawa 67s. Looking to have a big game in a town that he's comfortable in, a rink that he's played in and had some success.
And there he is, the 19-year-old boy wonder. He's been great this year for the Red Wings. 8 points, great plus-minus record so far. He's been the second-best player every night other than the goaltenders for the Red Wings, Zetterberg being number one.
You got Anderson trying to bounce back after two losses. His last two games against the Detroit Red Wings, he's lost both. He's looking to have a big bounce back. He's having a great season so far. He's looking to have a big game. Keep their three-win streak going.
And Bobby Ryan, this is a guy they lean on for goals, signs a big new contract, feels some pressure in Canada's capital. Only three so far, but this guy can pump the goals in. Gets 30 on most seasons in his career.
Wings have lost two in a row. The Sens have won two in a row. Whose streak comes to an end? We're about to find out as they tangle in Ottawa. Enjoy the game, everybody.